Hey guys, Zach Ricky providing you with another polymer tutorial. And today we have Rockwell Hardness of Plastics and Insulating Material, which is ASTM 785. Today you're going to need goggles and a lab coat. You're also going to need the indenter provided from the instructor. And you're also going to need material provided by the instructor. So now we're actually going to go about loading the machine and testing materials. So what you're going to do is you're going to take all five of these samples, load it into the machine like so, and you're going to tighten it so that the material actually comes in contact with the indenter, or this piece. So you're going to twist this clockwise. Now you'll notice that the machine is actually responding to us and the dials are actually zeroing out. So what you're going to do is you're going to make sure that this dial comes in contact with the dot and is lined up by spinning it even more. Now you can see that the dot is now in line with the arrow. But what we actually need to do to test this is make sure that the arrow is actually, or the dial is actually with the red 30. And as we can see, it's a little bit off. So what we need to do is take this button right here and adjust it so that the 30 is actually in line with the machine. Now we are ready to actually begin one sample of this test. The button I was referring to is actually just a slider right here that is used to make fine measurements in order to make sure that our needle is properly in place with the 30 mark. So what we're going to do is twist this so that it actually comes in contact with the 30 that we need to start the test. And that looks pretty lined up, and we are ready to begin one test of our sample. Now we'll begin testing the material, and we'll do that because our material is properly lined up and ready to go. So what we're going to do is push the button and drop the 60 kilogram load right behind the machine and start the sample test. As you can see, the dial is now moving. We have to wait for it to stop until we can begin the next step. As you can now see, the dial is getting very close to stopping. And now we will actually turn the next step. So what you're going to do now is you're going to see that there's a lever right next to you. And once this dial has stopped, you're going to rotate it towards you and make it so that this is your actual reading. So we're going to do that now. And it turns the dial back to what we actually want to read. This is what you'll record for your sample, and that's all you need to do. So once all set is done, we'll be reading from the red scale for our Rockwell hardness units, and as we can see, the smaller ticks will represent one half of the measurement. The larger ticks will represent just one measurement of the tick. The unit for this measurement will be 94 Rockwell hardness units. So once you've finished the first experiment, what you're going to do next is you're going to loosen this, and it's going to be clockwise, and you're going to loosen it so that you could actually rotate it and put it to another position in one of the five different positions that you're supposed to put in.